this run, we'll surely finish in record time. That last race that we just did was actually such a big meme. So one unfortunate thing though, is that I got the god power roll, and 4 mushroom drops from the enemies in early game, so I was able to save 10 seconds on Queen Bean, aside from like just having a fast dragon fight. Yeah, I blew it. But this time I'll get like the quick kills. That'll be better. Expert toad movement. Yeah, you need to leave, I want to say you'd need to leave twice, because you can get to Morton without anything, but you need to leave after Lemmy. Oh, maybe you would only have to leave once. But would low percent also count your advance commands for your attacks? I think it should count, so you can't just use Chopper Bros. That'd be much more funny. Yeah, this guy is all the way up. Yeah, need a plus one on every level up. Imagine holding straight. It was mid-controller switch to the GameCube D-pad. one cool thing about if this does get into GDQ is that I won't have to have the gamepad up there with me. That was a big lol when it was required to make save states. That I would have to like duck down and be on the ground for like 10 seconds. Hey Invert, TYTY for the good luck. Yikes, that was spooky. Good thing I didn't press A once more. I'm thinking ahead to the beanie if you win the speed tag. I think it might always just be better to attack with Mario first. On the dry bones instead of attacking him. On the beanie. Yeah, the beanie has like a short attack compared to the dry bones. That was awkward. I looked away from the screen and didn't notice I got a glitch. If you can one-shot the beanie, so if you get two power, or two twos on power, then I always go for the beanie first strike. Cause, you can skip, one of the attacks. Guaranteed with that. But I think it would always just be better to go for the dry bones. Because then there's still another chance to skip it, and then you would skip... You would always skip the slower attack. But then there is a chance to get three attacks instead of two. Also been thinking about jumping over that pit. Yep. Cause you can make it with regular jumps. Just another swag jump. Time to clean this run up. That was a little bit sloppy everywhere. Thank you. Good item drop. Now, Luigi got a one, feels bad. That means I have to counterattack on the flies because Luigi won't kill them one turn. He'll only do 2 damage instead of 3. Dang. No second mushroom. Nice, the double 2. Ah, hello? I messed that up, I forgot that I changed to attacking with Luigi earlier than usual. Luckily, doing that has no effect on the route, just have to press R one extra time. Luigi with the bad power, but luckily Mario already has enough to continue the run. If Mario can get another 2 on the Dry Bones fight, then I will switch to Luigi leveling up Stash early. Oh. One pixel off, she was blocking me. Who is attacking first? Me. Went for the guaranteed two turn. Alright, come on, Mario. Give me the two. Ah, like a frame late. Hello. Now, I hope Luigi gets a two. Nice. Yeah, so when Luigi doesn't have enough power, it really sucks because he doesn't do the minimum amount of damage you can do is six. And even though I leveled him up three times in power, he will still only do six. So really would have been nice to get at least a two there. Anything over 10 is good. Yeah, so Mario will only be doing 9. So I'll need 5 hits from him to kill. Thank you. right here. I'm gonna have Luigi bounce there. So I will get advanced commands a turn early. If Mario gets a 2 here, that would be nice. It's not required. Perfect. Yeah, so even though I had to take an extra turn on that fight, my dragon fight will still be the same amount. Nice. Yeah, ledge clubbing is useful for a little bit if you know where to use it. If you go, after you ledge clip to skip an area, if you go back to that area and do it normally, there's usually like a weird effect. Like if you go back to the mountain after you ledge clip, it's pretty funny, the camera gets messed up. Or like if you go back to Stardust Field and do the tutorial you skip with it. You like can soft lock. Damage. Okay. Okay, perfect. So now I will kill on Mario's fourth attack. Yeah, it doesn't matter when you get advanced commands on the Japanese version, because they take out having two cutscenes at the same time in battle. But you still want to do this in as little turns as possible. So here I get it a turn early. That's because I used an extra on Huhuris. Damage perfectly. Oh. Yeah, invisible door. There's some like weird pixel that you enter the door in that it just blocks you. Unfortunately, I cannot skip these items. You save a free 10 seconds if you can, but you need 4 item drops to do it. I only got one. Poggers. Got through the minecart. This will be a good segment if the enemies in the sewers cooperate.
Thank you.
tech smash. Fell off there without hammering. Alright. I aborted the mission on the first door, but I think it was a good decision. It was close to whether or not that would hit me. Give me my item, please. Alright. Pretty good. Looking to save most of the available time. Nice. Okay, whip. 30 power on Mario on that level. I should be doing exactly 30 damage on rookie. I'm pretty sure they're like just basically the same. It might be 31. But I think it would be 18 damage on Mario and 12 damage on Luigi's attack. It'll be 20 and 11. What? It doesn't matter, but I should learn these damage calculations better. You only need 29 now. Pretty sure. This will be 9 extra. So I'm pretty sure he dies in a jump now on Luigi's turn. He has 120 HP. Yep. Nice. I like it better when Luigi takes the death here. Thank you. Finally, it is that time of the run where we can get big old glitches again. Rip my high jump. Okay, good. That was all fast first try-ish on everything. Ah, I get stuck. Weird, Mario fell off on the top. Four, five, six, seven, eight. All right, that was good. 62. That was one coin off of another one, I'm pretty sure. Oh, big gold split, nice. Good. The worm did not pop on me this time. That was a clutch dodge. Dang, this is really close to being able to get 59 Kakaletta, but you would need like the perfect power for it. Get the mushroom. This time I will make sure to keep the action command. The mushrooms are evading me today. Can I get the quick kill this time? Huh. Why do I keep dropping it in the middle of it? It's very unfortunate. It should still be possible. It's the middle. Okay. This time it is top. Dang, no quick kill. Yeah, I dropped like... Oops. I dropped like 4 or 6 hits there. This might kill. Yeah. This one's much more lenient, but still, the first mashing of the run still takes a little time maybe to warm up. Or I'm just feeling a little bit tired, because I just did another run with Sork right now. Yeah, if I had done one more hit on Cacoletta, I would have skipped that cutscene, which would have been really nice. Going for another quick kill on the Popolin rookie fight that's coming up too. Saved my blank action command this time. I really dislike the viruses. They're so annoying to get around. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Shout out to Sork for telling me the fastest sequence for that. This quick kill is much more important than the Cacoletta one. So hopefully, it might honestly be my my button as well. Maybe it's a little too worn out. Oh no, that was very bad. I might try switching the controller for it. Yikes. This controller is worse with that mashing. I have to use my two fingers. Damn. Yeah, this is why it's important to get the quick kill. Because they do this attack in cutscene. Oh, he's not dead. That was much worse than I thought. Needed 5 hits. Yeah, I want to honestly blame it on my controller. Whatever. That's like the tightest one to do in the game. Yeah, in my PB, I also missed it. So I won't be losing much time to that, at least. Right there, I refreshed my controller, by the way. Not my controller. Refreshed my game feed so the audio doesn't desync. It should be fine for the rest of the run. Luckily, going for that quick heal. If we get Sin Sork, we'll be doing that part. Sork's, I think, pretty consistent at it, at least. I don't need to go that far because you warped to the middle there. Some areas you do, some areas you don't. Right here I got one Hermes shell. One Hermes hide and shell turn, so I could save time here. Even if I get one shell as well, I should save a little bit of time. That red shirt, that red hat. Are you Santa Claus? Oh, no. little bit better. I don't think that's like peak speed, but it is more consistent, so... I'm more consistent in what I've been doing, so it should be more hits. Yeah, I want to kill Hermie in 4 hits from Mario. Mario actually has more power, so Luigi's killing the claws earlier. Which makes a higher chance that, that Hermie will hide in shell, but it still would be like 50-50. Alright. So if all goes well, Mario will kill right now. There we go. Yeah, perfect Hermie fight. I'm gonna save a lot of time here. Yeah, and something new I will be doing is equipping the school slacks that I just got from Hermie. Me and Sark were just talking about it. It saves time when grinding for knockback because Luigi will go first. So normally, on enemies that Mario would kill, Luigi would get an extra knockback turn. Nice gold. I think I did one extra swap there. Okay, should be up 4. I think 2 more after this, so 3. Yeah, straight up. Whoops. It launched me in the middle there. This is also something new that I do, although it's not new to my PB. I did it first on the last one. Oops. But before I would... Give me a sec. that's fine. Before I would get the 9 pipe, right before going there. Oops. But getting it now saves time. And then there's no risk of losing glitches or anything later on, which was a problem with the old route. Spooky. No, I got the bag. You can at least heal Mario. Or not give him a mushroom at all. Oh, I also forgot to equip the slacks. Whoops. I'll do that right now after this fight. Yeah, double bag. Yeah, this bag is a really slow attack that you don't want to see. You want him to try and steal stuff from you or just trample you. Should be dead next turn. Yo, triple bag. This is unfortunate. The only benefit you get from the bag attack is maybe you get some extra coins, enough to buy one or two extra mushrooms. But it wastes like 15 seconds. Right. Kill this, maybe? Wow. Normally you'd get enough counterattacks to kill with Luigi's turn there, but since he's only using bag, I have to do an extra hit. Thank you, RNG God. Probably like one or two hits away. Trying to think of when the best time to equip would be. I don't think there really is any good time, because I don't really need to use the pause menu. Do it in the Wiggler room. So the effect on those pants makes Luigi always go before Mario, Also, I went 4 instead of 5, whoops. And that's what gives me an extra hit every time, so I gain knockback faster. Because normally when you grind for knockback, you would have to wait for an enemy to attack as well. This one, you just get a free turn with no backdraw or drawbacks. I will have to make sure to take it off for the death warp though, so I can't sell my... I can't sell anything. Oh wait, what? Sork. This is the pants to go right after Mario. That's actually really funny, I gotta tell Sork that. What is it? You get the pants drop from Hermie, he always drops it. But the correct pants that Sork and I would want is Scandal Jeans, because it makes Luigi always go before Mario. But this one is the school slacks, which makes Luigi always go right after Mario. But this is also still good. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's really funny, I gotta tell him. This pants will still be helpful though. Not as helpful as what we originally thought. The reason for that is because now on, every enemy will be faster than Mario. So this doesn't even change turn order. It was only helpful for, like, Popple. Like, Popple and Wiggler. And Birdo, actually. Birdo's really slow. There's also another quick kill on this fight too that I want to get. I want to kill on Mario's turn right here before he transforms. There we go. Will both of these guys level up or just one? Yeah, after Birdo, I want to take these off. Oh, where am I going? That was just a coin, so it wasn't needed. let's see. After Birdo, Mario one-shots Trunkle and Trunkle goes first. Jojora, you always kill with three shots on Mario. Like, you don't get an extra knockback from that. And same thing for none of the Koopalings. I think I should save some time right now, because it is useful on Mom Piranha. Especially if Mario goes before her. I think this fight sequence will go as, we'll go like this. Mario attack, Mom Piranha counter attack, and then Luigi attack the baby piranha plants, so only one of them gets a turn instead of two. And same with Birdo, because Mario should be faster than Birdo right now. Right input, please. Thank you. Yeah, this area is the only area where we specifically need Thunderhand, so we're able to skip it. Everything else we can get past by barrel clipping or something. No, we restarted because Sork like died on Cacoletta and on the Popplin rookie fight, so he had to like waste 10 minutes. And then I messed up a glitch and also had to waste like 3 or 4 minutes. Since we didn't have time for like another race, I just saw her headed out and I'm just doing another PB attempt. No winning sub for Zill, feels bad. Yeah, next race, sub on the line. Yeah, but I don't think me and Sork will be able to get another race in before tomorrow, so we'll just be submitting our individual PBs. Why am I pausing? I just had to walk in a straight line. Oh no, that is not good enough to kill in 2 hits, I think. Ouch. But this is good, because Mom Piranha will still... one attack, slash, will only heal 10. Bad fight, but oh well. Ouch. Yeah, and it's a fast attack for her to just respawn. Maya's still leveling up here. Both the boys are, actually. Aw. Yeah, I'm wondering if I accidentally switched my controllers, because I have 2 white GameCube controllers. And I might have switched my Majora's Mask controller with this one. That, or I just have worn out my A button a little too much. This is a pretty good cutscene. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm already just gonna take off the... okay, yeah. I'm already just gonna take off the school slacks. Yeah, I have an extra golden mushroom, nice. I forgot who dropped that, that's hype. Oh, no. What? How'd this guy hit me? I can't run yet, I'll save time because in my PB I got pipe 6, but it's unneeded. Oh, yeah. But that was unfortunate that I got first struck by that guy. Thought it was far enough to the left, but I don't think I gave myself enough space, and that's the reason why it hit. I shouldn't switch there, I should just hit with B. That won't work because I accidentally moved while not in the air. That dry bones on the bottom gave me a quick shot, but luckily I was out of the way. I forgot my gold tier, actually Mario dies because his HP was so low, but that's a very like niche situation that has only happened to me that one time. The only way that would happen again is if Popple does the jump attack. Because Birdo will actually one-shot both Mario and Luigi with her attacks. Like right here. Nice. So I am able to save more time. But only if Popple either kills Mario or attacks Luigi here again. Mario. Nice. Does Luigi only get one here? Cool. Yeah, that's very rare. Going through that pipe actually clears your glitch commands while keeping the glitch intact. So when I switch back to Luigi in front, I'll still have barrel. know. Shit. Yeah, I'm gonna run. That's unfortunate. I have to go back and do this whole room. Ugh, damn it. Alright, that's... I lost like 2 minutes there. I don't know why I've been having so much trouble. Luigi didn't want to jump on that area. And that cutscene, when cutscenes happen in the game, everything's supposed to freeze, but Peach did not freeze on that. Jeez. The barrel stayed intact, nice. I don't understand why he didn't get me there, but he got me on the others. It really sucks. So I lost all my lead. Dang, really unfortunate that happened. I'm pretty sure that was like, he didn't jump up because I was too far to the right. But the barrel is bigger than Luigi normally is in the left and the right. So if he wasn't in barrel, it would have worked. Alright, so what's the level ups here? Dang, that really sucks. Oh well. I'd have to be more careful on that next time. Okay, 43. This can still, like, 228 if I play really well. Really, I got that jump out? Bye. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Good. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. I was like caught on some invisible wall or something. Maybe the barrel's hitbox just extended that far, and that was really weird. Changing hair color is good. No, she's back already. So I'm gonna get a counterattack here. Yeah, it's really unlucky when she does, when what's her face comes back on turn 1 instead of turn 2. Just random. Yeah, so now since she healed like 6 or 7 hits, I'll have to do an extra turn. Thing to give me a slow attack too. Depending on level ups, it could be 20 to 30 seconds lost. It's probably looking like 40, honestly. They're only doing one, which is good. Okay. 2 minutes ahead of the world, Ricky. Surely we can get through the castle without losing, like, 5. Don't know what happened to Sork here, though. Can I get a fast death warp? Yep, nice. Alright. Alright, now kill Luigi. Perfect. Unfortunate that Luigi, they didn't die on the same turn. But that was still the second fastest death warp. That's like a free 10 seconds saved on my, what is it? On my Lemmy gold segments. have to be careful because I need to keep spin jump throughout half of the next area. Good. Not get caught by that guy this time. Should be good. Alright, so I'm gonna farm. Knock back on this guy like 5 times. Then I will go for the kill. Give me some spins. Nice. Okay. Four. I do have a lot of extra because I failed some quick kills and other stuff like that. And awesome, I'm already at 14 damage. It's really good. Leave me alone, fire. Get away from me. Alright, good. I chose a good time to get out. Because I was on a really fast cycle with the Sniffits. Whoops. I accidentally switched. So I'm gonna get out of the way of this one. Yeah, you don't have time to switch twice in there. Thank you. I don't like farming on Morton knockback because his stuff, oops, his things on average are slower, his attacks. Like, he never really does one fire. I think his average is 4 to 5. It's not good to fail knockback. So I should not do that again. Might be dead this turn. Yeah. Would've been nice to get one more knockback in there, but oh well. Yeah, so now I want knockback on Lemmy before I kill him. So this is why we needed to keep spin jump for this room. And once we have that, we can get rid of it. So this cutscene is RNG. Best case is you get second try, worst is 5. So I'm gonna Chopper Bros once on Lemmy, and then continue to jump with Mario until Luigi gets knockback bros. Gets super optimized, it'll be important to get it the correct amount on Iggy. Iggy is the fastest. Should be only needing like 5 or 6 though. This one maybe? I don't keep like exact count. But as soon as Luigi gets it, Mario will be able to kill him on the next turn. Yeah, where is it? Maybe I shouldn't have believed Sork saying only grind for 5. If I was gonna grind this much, I should have emptied out on Iggy. There it is. saving 20 seconds. Oh, 30 seconds, nice. Grab this one up for safety. Shouldn't need it though, now that I have knockback advance though. Ah, damn it. It's really hard to get this in one cycle, but I should have been able to time that for a two cycle hit. There we go. Oops, keep hammer. I should be able to gold by about 2 minutes. Lost some of that time through that Mecha Koopa watering hole, but still should be able to do a lot with this. If Ludwig would hurry up. I already got 14, so I want to do like 25 hits, I think. That should be good. The chopper bro should kill right here. Hoping he would have given me spin attack instead of shell, that's the fastest. Yeah, 25 might have been overkill already. And he actually dropped equipment. I'm pretty sure that's not 100%. I should look into seeing if that could be helpful for maybe Roy. Roy is the hardest boss in the game, I think, for surviving. Oops. So maybe trying to keep that for him. With the extra defense from that, pants that he got for Luigi, I might be able to survive 3 or 4 hits from Roy instead of just 1 or 2. Nice. I can save a bunch of time on this Roy fight because I messed up my advanced command, my advanced knockback a lot on my gold. Yeah, Mario 1 complete. Funny thing, if you actually hit these blocks on the same frame, it doesn't work. Roy, I want to do like 45 hits on. Okay, good. Nice, 11. And this is the attack I wanted to avoid. It's really hard to dodge. And then his fire breath actually is impossible for Mario to dodge. Alright, let's go for 30 now. Or still 35 probably. Nice. I don't know why I can't do it on Roy. Yeah, that's actually, I don't think Mario can dodge it. Okay. Hopefully we have a million one-ups. So this won't be too bad as long as Mario kills right here. And it should be possible. Dang. Just a little more. He's dead on next turn, guaranteed. Oops. Yeah, this is like the longest attack in the game. That's why I like to get knocked back. But I'm a big chugster on Roy, feels bad. Yep. Can still probably save like a minute, honestly, on this, so that's good. But if I want a world record, I can't miss knockback on the final fights. Let's go! Okay, so. Good. That's always a scary room to do. Because if you miss it, that's a one-off trick. You have to go all the way back down and get glitches again. Windy should take three. If I'm a god, I can maybe get it in two, but that's really hard. I don't think it's possible for me at the moment. Okay, whatever. Her ring attacks really fast. So that's what I'm hoping for. Fire attack, not fast at all. Give me the rings. Nice. And she is dead. Yikes, longer than expected. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That was pretty good. Just need a not soft lock here, which I figured out how to do consistently. There we go. Fast. Okay. I think 25 should do it. tennis on Mario or something else fast. That's even better. Alright. Only saving like 30 seconds, depending on level up. Alright, so this is 229 pace, if I don't get hit here. Perfect. And since I already have 14 damage, I can just go straight. Alright, if I can do 32 hits in a row, this will be a big goal, then very likely to be 229. But I need that 32 hits. If I miss one, it might be over. Especially depending on how far into it I get. Five hits, nice. Not the end of the world. Should be it. Alright. Big gold. Definitely the 229 about to happen right now. Maybe even 228 if I don't bust her out, or I can bust her out once or twice. I think I want to just do 45 on this instantly, because Balletta has slow attacks. 25. Oh, this will be faster. I got really lucky on attacks. Yeah. It's scary to do it on Valletta. Because Starstorm is really common when she's low on health. But if you can do it on... You can do a two-turn without Starstorm, you save 20 seconds. But that's just RNG. Funny thing is that I need to do 25 damage or 25 hits with knockback to get the two turns, so it was like perfect. Nuts. No! I can't let her, can't let her kill on Mario's turn. Otherwise, I would have to do an extra. Alright, 40 hits, or 45 hits. I'll go over 50, just to make sure it's 100% true. Maybe could have gotten the 28 if I went straight 45. Yeah, I didn't mind though. GG's. Yeah, don't sell lock on Larry. Get in there. What the heck? That's cheating. Alright. It was a little bit slow, so I'm thinking 229.05. Which is actually a much nicer looking time than 229.04. So not the worst thing to happen. But I also maybe could have golded this. I don't remember if I've ever gotten like a really good escape. Dang. 229.04. Yay. PogChamp! Yeah, Wombologist PhD. Just noticed, what a great name. GG's, GG's. I am also a fan of Sponge. Alright. Since this is the world record, I'll upload it to YouTube since it is significant. It's also the first 229, under 230. I remember when I first started running this game. When I started running this game, this time was like a 315. Yeah, and then Vlack was the first person to like reroute everything. Like Altabiscuits was able to take it down to like sub 3. And Vlack was the first person to optimize everything to originally get it down to sub 250 and then 239. And then Sork came in, but I beat him to it, the 229. Yeah. The early game was pretty good. I didn't get the god power or anything. I got pretty good, so I saved maybe 20 out of the 40 seconds there. But that's just RNG, so I didn't mind anything at all. Cacletta through, what is it? Popple just had a bit of bad luck, especially on Popple. But I wasn't mashing my fastest at that point yet, so I didn't miss the quick kill on Cacletta and Popple and Rookie. And some shenanigans when happened over here too in Trunkle. But aside from that, I did gold every split after. But I definitely think a really, really good sum of best could be 219. And I think at this point with the route, if I try to super optimize it, like I did with any percent, or if Sork wants to grind that far too, a 224, 223, honestly, could be possible. Yay. But yeah. That was a good run. And luckily I had a PG, well, I guess I'm always PG, but nothing got me angry or anything through messing up. It was just good all around, so I feel like I had good stage presence or whatever, so I can submit this time for AGDQ.